Hi, my name is Emad AbouElgheit and I'm a digital marketing strategist for tech startups. In this video, I'm going to talk about the first step in building your digital marketing strategy for your new app, new software as a service, or enterprise software. So, in the 7 steps strategic planning process, the first step is the analysis, how to conduct a situational analysis. The situational analysis is like a checklist to look what is internal, what is competitive, and what is external to your organization. For example, you start by looking inside your company or your organization. Start by looking at your product or your portfolio of products. What are the strengths and weaknesses? Do they need improvements? Have you been receiving complaints from users on your app? How competitive the features are? What is the plan for improvements or updates to the app, for example? Look at your team, how strong your team is as a culture and as a unique set of skills. What are their strengths and weaknesses? Look at your capital and your financial resources. Are you low in budget? Do you need to have another round of investment? Are you ready to scale? Do you have the financial assets to help you move forward or not? Look at your digital assets. That's really important since we are talking about digital marketing strategy. Look at your existing assets, how strong you are now in app store search, for example. How strong are you now in search engine, organic results? Does your website needs to be updated? How important the website is for your customers anyway? Do you have strong engaged users on your social media pages or not? Also look at your processes, how you actually do business, especially if you are in a B2B tech environment. How does your marketing team deal with your sales team? What is the sales funnel? Do you have like an automated CRM system? How is the lead generation and lead nurturing goes? Do you need to streamline those processes or to build new processes? So that is for the internal situation. Next, you need to look at the competitive environment a little bit outside of your organization. For example, if you are building a new dating app, what is the current market leaders in this category in Apple App Store or in Google Play Store in dating apps and social apps? What are their current rankings in search on these app stores? What are their daily active users? How many active users they actually have? Number of downloads? How much revenue they generate? How to get that information? You have platforms, for example, like App Annie, like AppTweak. Those are app store optimization software that can give you a little bit of market intelligence on competitors' apps. Some of those metrics can be found on the app store's metrics themselves publicly, and some of those metrics are only available through these third-party platforms. Another example, if you're building a headset for augmented reality, what is the risk of other companies entering that category or entering that market on a global scale or a local scale? How is that actually can be a strength or weaknesses or an opportunity or threat compared to your product? Next, you need to look at the external environment. The most important thing when we talk about building a digital marketing strategy is to look at trends. Trends in user behavior and online user behavior change a lot, so you need to keep a close eye on those trends. Some tools to help you in gaining some insights on user trends, for example, Google AdWords Planner, Google Search Volume Estimation, see the trends, see what people are searching for in the last week or the last month in specific location, read industry report published ones. Websites like We Are Social, for example, can give you great insights about social media penetration and social media platform usage and influence. Another important thing to look at the macro environment or the external is the technological changes. For example, there is a lot of momentum that is being gained by wearable technologies, for example, like smart shoes, smart watches, smart shirts. How's that gonna impact your business or your product? And how's that can be leveraged into an up. Next, you need to understand how your users or your target audience make a decision to buy something online. For example, if they're buying a travel deal, what kind of websites they use to compare deals and what kind of websites they use to actually conduct the purchase, and what influences them during that decision-making process. After you went through all the internal, competitive, and external environments checklist and identified what is can be a strength for you, a weakness, an opportunity, or threat, you will end up seeing something like that. This is a result of your entire analysis in simple, like 3 or 5 bullet points in each box in your digital marketing plan. Strengths and weaknesses are internal to your organization. You have control over them. Opportunities and threats happen anyway in the macro environment, but they do impact your business, but you don't have control over them, okay? So, for example, a strength box can contain, like, you have a strong patent, you have an existing good position in search engine, you have a large user base that can be like strength for your company or your product. Your weaknesses can be having low funds, no marketing team. Your opportunities can be something, again, you don't have control over it. Growth of wearable technology, for example. You have economic growth in foreign markets that enables them to make more transactions online. Your threats could be high risk of new entrants. You are in a product category that is very easy and very popular for other companies to make similar products to. So that can be considered a threat. Another threat could be higher shipping cost for your e-commerce business, for example. So it's an additional cost that you will have to add to the users and raise your price. So your SWOT table would look something like that. Now, why this is important? Why do we bother making that table? This SWOT table will actually help you base your strength. For example, if one of your strengths is good search engine position, and you have an opportunity at the same time of a growth of wearable technology, you may use your search engine good positions to start to rank high for this category of wearable technologies when people look for it. Another example, if you have a good user base, a lot of engaged users follow you and like your pages on social media, and you are low in funds, you can rely on those users to incentivize them to be a referral and do viral marketing for your campaign. So illustrating that SWOT table in terms of strength, opportunities, weaknesses, and threats help you to actually build your strategy, which we will come to at later videos. I hope you enjoyed watching that video about the first step in building a digital marketing strategy, which is conducting the situational analysis. Again, my name is Emad AbouElgheit, and I'm a digital marketing strategist. If you have any questions or comments, please leave comments and subscribe to the channel if you like the video. If you're interested in a one-on-one digital marketing audit for your own business, let me know on the email below, and I'll be happy to do so. See you in next videos.